Okay, so now let us talk of reported questions. Right? So, any. Right? Any verbs like asked, inquired, wondered, wanted to know, all these are question verbs, right? They ask questions, even tried to find out, etc., right? But we never use said. Said is a statement, right? So whenever said, he said comes, it is a statement, it is not a question. He asked, he inquired, he wondered, that all these, right, are questions. Yeah, but if you say he said, where do you live? So where do you live is a question, okay? Remember this. So relative pronoun, that is never used. We never use said that, okay? Question mark is replaced by inverted commas at the end. There are two types of questions which begin with question words, or we can say these are WH question, where, why, where, how, why, wait, or why, which, etc. And which do not begin with question words. They are yes, no questions. Questions whose answers can be yes and no. They don't begin with question words. Let's see examples. Where have you been this afternoon? The mother asked her son. See, this is a question. This is a question word, right? Where? So the answer would be the mother asked her son where. We will have to use this word where, and then we use the subject where he, and then had. Okay? So where he had been, this becomes that afternoon. So the answer would be the mother asked her son where he had been that afternoon. Which subject you like most? The teacher asked the students. See, again, same question word. Na? The teacher asked the students which subject they liked the most. Okay? So, subject always comes before the verb. Right? The subject comes before the verb. Like in this case, they subject comes before the verb. Now, questions which are yes-no type questions, whose answer is yes-no, they don't begin with question words. Like, did you watch TV last night? The answer is yes or no. Tom asked me. So, Tom asked me, you can use the word if, or you can use the word whether also. Right? So, Tom asked me whether or if, right? You can use if. If I had watched TV the night before. See, simple past becomes past perfect. So, Tom asked me if I had watched TV the night before. Right? Forgive Tom. Right? He's in Jerry, sorry. Na? He's in a bad mood. Both of them are fighting a lot. Okay. So, can you answer this question? The teacher asked John. See, again, it's a yes-no question. The teacher asked John if or whether he could. He could answer that question. Okay, so we use normally, instead of whether, better to use if. Okay, what are you studying? He asked her. Again, see, WH question, right? He asked her what she, no, her, no, see, he asked her. So he asked her what she was studying. Right? Present continuous becomes past continuous, right? Do you like the apple? See, again, it's a yes-no question. The farmer asks Bill. So, the farmer asks Bill if he liked the apple. Right? Now, let's talk of commands. Order, command. A verb giving an order becomes an infinitive. To. We use to. Okay? So verb said becomes told. Or ordered, or asked, or commanded, or requested, or begged, etc. Add the person to whom the order was given. Like negative command, if is here, not to, we use not to. Okay? So said, told to, ordered to, asked to, and in negative, not to. Okay? See, let's take example. Touch your toes, he said to us. So he told us. Instead of said to, we are going to use, he told us to touch our toes. Right? He told us to touch our toes. Don't lie down, he said to me. तो ही ऑर्डर्ड अस और ही ऑर्डर्ड मी नॉट टू, सी यहाँ पे डू नॉट है, नॉट नेगेटिव है, नॉट टू लाई डाउन. तो ही ऑर्डर्ड मी नॉट टू लाई डाउन, ही टोल्ड मी नॉट टू लाई डाउन ऑल्सो विल डू. फायर, द लुटेनेंट सेड. तो द लुटेनेंट ऑर्डर्ड और कमांडेड ही सोल्जर्स टू फायर, राइट. द लुटेनेंट कमांडेड और ऑर्डर्ड ही सोल्जर्स टू फायर. नाउ लेट अस टॉक ऑफ एक्सक्लेमेशन एंड यस नो. नो डेफिनेट रूल्स फॉर चेंजिंग इन टू इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच आर देयर फॉर एक्सक्लेमेशन यस नो. लाइक ऑफन यू से रिमार्क, एक्सक्लेम, ग्रीट, शाउट, गिव एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ सरप्राइज एक्सेट्रा, राइट, इन एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क. एग्जाम्पल वी सी, सो वॉट अ बिग हाउस ही सेड. सो वी कैन से ही एक्सक्लेम्ड विद सरप्राइज दैट इट वॉज अ बिग हाउस, और ही एक्सक्लेम ही सेड दैट इट वॉज अ बिग हाउस. दैट्स इट. वी कैन एड विद सरप्राइज और विद वंडर, राइट, एनी इन्फिनिटिव और एनी थिंग वी कैन एड अप योर. हाई जॉन, टॉम सेड, लवली डे इजंट इट. सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज हाई जॉन. सो टॉम ग्रीटेड जॉन. देखो, वी डोंट से हाई, वी नेवर यूज हाई. हाई, यस, नो, वी नेवर यूज हाई. बाय टॉम ग्रीटेड जॉन एंड एक्सक्लेम्ड दैट इट वॉज अ लवली डे, और रिमार्क्ड, सी, टॉम ग्रीटेड जॉन एंड रिमार्क्ड, और वी कैन से एक्सक्लेम्ड दैट इट वॉज अ लवली डे. इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्सक्लेम वी कैन यूज द वर्ड रिमार्क्ड, बिकॉज इट्स अ रिमार्क, राइट. Yes, no are also reported by subject plus auxiliary verb. Do, does, and did. Right? See, have you had your lunch? Sam asked. Yes, Paul replied. Dekho, it's a complex, it's a mixed sentence. So Sam asked whom? Paul, right? So Sam asked Paul if, because this is a yes, no question, right? Sam asked Paul if he have becomes had. So he had, two times had, right? His lunch. And Paul confirmed or affirmed. See, Sam asked Paul if he had had his lunch, and Paul replied that he had, or we can just say Paul affirmed. And he, yes, is affirmed. No, is a negative. Did you watch the TV program last night? Mary asked Sue. No, Sue replied. So see, Mary asked Sue if she had watched, past tense, right? If he, she, so simple past becomes past perfect. If she had watched the TV program the night before. Sue denied. No means said no. Or Sue replied that she had not. Okay? Or Sue denied. How poor the report is, the manager said. Again, this is an exclamation mark. The manager exclaimed that the report was very poor. Or the report was poor. That's it. The manager remarked, we can say. Exclaim, instead of exclaim, we are using remarked up here. Now let's see mixed type of questions. A suitable introductory verb. Don't play with that knife, Sally. Mrs. Chan said, you'll hurt yourself. Now see, Mrs. Chan is saying two things. She's ordering Sally not to play with that knife, and she's also telling her that she will hurt herself. This is a command, this is a statement. So, Mrs. Chan ordered Sally or told Sally not to play with that knife, and added that she would hurt herself. Will becomes would. Let's see, the answer would be Mrs. Chan told Sally. Where is it gone? Okay. Mrs. Chan told Sally not to play with that knife and told her that she would hurt herself. Okay, next thing. You look beautiful in that dress, Jane, Paul said. How much did it cost you? See, first is a statement, and next is a question. So Paul told Jane that. See, Paul told Jane that she looked beautiful in that dress. And asked, see, this is a question, right? And asked how much it costed her. Oh, it had cost her, right? Because this is simple past. Simple past becomes past perfect. Now we use either or as or because or since or a participle. Let's say, where did you buy the dress, you? I'd like to get one for my sister, James said. So we can make it short like this. James wanted to know where Sue had bought. No, see, had bought that dress from, as he wanted to get one for his sister. Okay, don't go to bed late. Remember, you'll have to get up early tomorrow, Peggy's mother said. All mothers tell children the same thing every day. So, first is a command and second is a statement, right? So, what will we write? Peggy's mother told her, command, right? Not to, see, do not, no, not to go to bed late. Reminding her that she would have, you will become she would, have to get up early the next day. Do you like to have a bowl of rice? The chef said to Don, said to John, this is a question. We don't have any other food here. This is a statement, see. So the chef asked John if he would like to have a bowl of rice and said that, or and stated that they did not have any other food there. See, the chef asked John if he liked to have, or he would like to have a bowl of rice and said that they don't have any other food there, or they did not have any other food there. Okay, so this completes the basic introduction to direct and indirect sentences, right? Now, it would do you good to see the video once or twice and then try to solve exercises, but keeping in mind the change of tenses as much as possible. This is a comparatively hard thing to do, change of direct to indirect. Many students find it a little tough, but with practice and with proper knowledge of tenses, if you are finding direct indirect hard, first get your tenses right. Learn all the 12 tenses properly. Learn to convert from one tense to another. Once you can do that, then converting direct to indirect or would be comparatively easy for you. So hope you try. Any doubts, you can get back to us. We'll help you out, right? So all the best. Bye.